Hello everyone and welcome. In today's video, I'll go over Holy Paladin talents, traits and playstyle for Arena. The goals in this video will teach you about positioning and playstyle as a Holy Paladin, which will make it easier to keep your team offensive. Holy Paladin still relies heavily on cooldowns and burst healing to top a target. Your go-to comms will be comms where you're looking to finish the game fast, so you can rotate cooldowns with your team until you score a kill. The longer the game lasts, the harder it will be to keep your team offensive. Melee cleaves like TSG, Turbo or DHDK all offer this fast-paced playstyle and are all looking very strong. If you do not want to play a melee cleave, a melee ranged comp like KFC, Mage Warrior or Armpala are all good options to play instead. If you're looking to play a spell cleave, Mage Lock Pala or Boomy Mage Pala are both good options. Your standard talent build will look like this. Unbreakable Spirit, Cavalier and Rule of Law can be swapped depending on what comp you face. Unbreakable Spirit is a good pick versus RMP. Cavalier is good when getting trained by melee cleaves. And Rule of Law is good on big maps like Tolvaron so you can stay max range. Fist of Justice, Repentance and Blinding Light can be picked depending on what comp you play. Blinding Light is better when playing with a melee cleave. Fist of Justice is better when playing with a Mage or Hunter. And Repentance is best when playing with a Warlock or Boomkin. For your PvP talents, you should always play Blessed Hands and Light's Grace. Ultimate Sacrifice can be swapped out for Cleanse the Weak or Divine Favor. Cleanse the Weak is a good pick versus Rot comps with an Affliction Warlock or Shadow Priest. And Divine Favor is a good pick when you expect to get trained for the majority of the game. The best Azerite trait for Holy Paladin is still Radiant Incandescence. You should stack this trait as much as you can for Arena, since stacking this trait 3 times will make most of your Holy Shocks apply a big hot onto the target. Your playstyle will slightly depend on what comp you play. When playing a melee cleave, you will play more aggressive, and when playing a melee caster comp or spell cleave, you will play more passively. These playstyle goals apply to nearly every comp, and applying them will help you improve your gameplay as a Holy Paladin. Positioning. Holy Paladins are very vulnerable to CC and swaps, since you're always casting to try and top a target. Positioning and avoiding CC or swaps is your first goal to keep your team offensive. Poor positioning can result in eating more CC or opening yourself up to swaps, which will make you lose the majority of your games. Jumping into this clip, I'm facing RMP, which has a lot of CC and swap potential. As you can see, I'm playing at the pillar, so I can avoid both CC and a swap onto me. Playing like this makes it extremely hard for the mage to land CC on me, and makes it hard for the enemy team to perform a swap. The enemy rogue is looking for a swap onto me, but by hugging the pillar, I can line of sight him and avoid him until I'm stable on health again. Try to position yourself at a pillar as much as possible, since it will make it harder for the enemy team to land CC or swaps onto you. In a clip shown before, if I decided to leave the pillar, I would have most likely died in a swap, or get caught in a CC chain while the enemy team kills one of my DPS. Sack incoming CC. When playing offensive, or when the enemy team pushes in, avoiding CC can be hard. To counter this, you can use your Blessing of Sacrifice to break incoming CC and save your partners at the same time. Sacking incoming CC will save cooldowns for you and your team, since you will most likely have to use a trinket and another cooldown, or have your partners use a bunch of cooldowns to survive the setup. In this clip, my DK has no cooldowns left, and I don't have my trinket ready for a while. If a CC chain lands on me, it means I would have to use my bubble to save my DK. Instead, I use Blessing of Sacrifice right before the priest lands the fear on me. After the fear breaks, I can get to safety and top myself. In this clip, my team wants to go offensive right away, and I can't avoid any CC since I'm in the middle of the map. The hunter moves towards me for a trap, and use Blessing of Sacrifice to break it. This way I can keep my team offensive while they go for an aggressive opener. In both of these clips shown before, I use Blessing of Sacrifice to break incoming CC. If I decided not to use Blessing of Sacrifice, my partners would have to use multiple cooldowns to survive, or I would have to use Trinket or Bubble and use Blessing of Sacrifice anyway. By breaking incoming CC with Blessing of Sacrifice, both these scenarios can be avoided. Fake cast. Holy Paladins are very vulnerable to interrupts, since they're constantly casting to keep the team topped. Knowing how to fake cast players is a big part of playing a Holy Paladin in PvP. In this clip, I'm facing RMP and I don't have a lot of cooldowns left to keep my team topped. When I come out of the blind, I pop my wings and quickly use Holy Shock to connect a heal on my DK. I start casting Holy Light to try and bait the enemy team into using their interrupts on me, and I bait both kick and counterspell from the enemy team. After this, I can cast freely and top my team. If I decided not to fake cast in the previous clip, my DK would have most likely died. Practice your fake casting by using short and quick casts to try and bait interrupts from players. Some players kick extremely fast and some players tend to hold onto their kick. Figure this out for yourself during the game and adjust your casting accordingly. Rotate cooldowns. Holy Paladins have to rotate cooldowns with their team to keep them aggressive. Overlapping cooldowns can result in losing your games more than with any other healer, since Holy Paladin has a strong cooldown kit but weaker healing than most other healers. In the next clip, I'm facing RMP and I decide to sit the CC chain. I communicate with my team to use a cooldown while I sit the CC chain. Let's jump into the clip and see what happens. Blinded, I'm gonna sit this.
Sure. Can't stop poly.
Sat. They have heal and stuff. Use the.
I have trigger heal.
Big poly.
You're off here, I'm gonna suck your.
Okay. Ripping sheep. He got PS.
Thank you, Peter. Do you stun out?
Good communication with your team can help you to avoid overlapping cooldowns. Personally, I prefer to call cooldowns as a healer so my DPS can focus on other aspects of the game. Keep your team mobile. Slows, roots, and CC can all keep your team from doing damage and keeping up pressure. Make sure that you keep your team aggressive with freedoms and dispels so they can keep doing damage and forcing cooldowns. Poor dispelling and poor use of hand of freedom will make your team lose pressure and gives the enemy team a chance to recover. In this clip, my DPS decide to train the enemy healer. Since the warrior will instantly charge and stop my DK from connecting, I give him hand of freedom as soon as the warrior connects. This way, he can go aggressive instantly and start creating pressure. In this clip, I'm facing Thundercleave, and since the shaman can purge my hand of protection, I use it to remove bash from my demon hunter instead to keep him offensive. Go for CC when your team has pressure. When your team has pressure and can score a kill, you should leave the pillar and start playing aggressive to finish the game. Landing a CC like Hammer of Justice or Blinding Light can set up CC chains for your team or force cooldowns, for example a trinket, from the enemy team. In this clip, my team has pressure and the enemy team has no cooldowns left. When my Hammer of Justice comes off cooldown, I move towards the enemy healer to stun him and my DPS can finish the game by killing the mage. Knowing when to leave the pillar is important. If you run into the open to land CC too early, it could result in the enemy team forcing cooldowns from you instead. Leave the pillar just after coming out of CC, or when your team has a bunch of cooldowns left and the enemy team is completely out of cooldowns. That's gonna be it for this guide, guys. Please leave a plus kill if you enjoyed it and let me know what you think in the comments. And I'll see you guys next time.